Hello everyone. In today's video lecture, we are going to discuss about lichens. What lichen is? Lichen is basically a composite organism. In this composite organism, a fungus is living with very intimate relationship with a cyanobacterium or with a green algae. So basically, a lichen is a close association of these two portions. One is mycobiont and another is phycobiont. The phycobiont is algal portion or cyanobacterium, where the mycobiont is fungal portion. The association of algae and fungi in lichen is a symbiotic association in which both the mycobiont and the phycobiont help each other. The term lichen was first of all used by Theophrastus. So Theophrastus gave the term lichen. The study of lichens is known as lichenology, and the scientist who studies the lichen are known as lichenologist. Lichenologist. Erik Acrius, in 1980, he studied a lot of lichen, their morphology and their physiology. So he is considered as father of lichens. So Erik Acrius is known as father of lichenology. Now we will talk about the occurrence of lichens. Till now, we have seen around 17 to 20,000 species of lichen worldwide. They are cosmopolitan, and there are around 400 genera of lichen which are found worldwide. Lichens are generally found in exposed rock surface, as well as they can be found on the glass windows. They can be found on the tree trunk, on the branches of the tree, and on the cork of the tree. As well as you can see them on the roof of the houses also. Lichens are very much sensitive to the pollution. If there is pollution of sulfur dioxide in the atmosphere, the lichen will quickly start dying. So in such a way, we can make out that the pollution is increasing in the atmosphere. So they are very good indicator of pollution. Now we will discuss about the habit and habitat of different lichens. As we all know that lichen are found worldwide, so what are the different habitats in which we can find them? So here is the first habitat, that is arboreal. Arboreal means they are living on the trees, and the example of such lichen is Parmelia. Next is corticollis. Corticollis means if any lichen is living on the bark of a tree, then it will be known as the corticollis. Example of it is Physia as well as Parmelia. Both of them are example of corticollis lichen. Next is lignicollis. If any lichen is found on the wood, you can see them on the door, on the window pane, anywhere on the wood, then the lichen will be known as lignicollis. Okay, and the example of lignicollis lichen is Calcicum. Next is Pterycollis. Pterycollis is the lichen which is terrestrial and which is residing on the surface of the land. And example of such lichen is Cladonia and Peltigera. Next are Saxicollis lichens. Saxicollis lichens found on the rocks, or they can be considered as lithocollis because they are residing on the rocks. Example of it is Rhizocarpon. And next is Omnicollis. Omnicollis lichen can be found anywhere on the surface. They can be found on the, you know, teeth. They can be found on the glass, pieces of glass. They can be found on the bones. So these are known as Omnicollis, and example of it is Xanthophora. A part of it, some lichen can be seen in the polar region where there is a lot of ice. And example of it is Cladonia rangifera, which is very important lichen. It is also known as reindeer moss. And this is very important question which comes repetitively in various examination, be it NEET, be it NET, or any competitive exam. So just remember this, Cladonia rangifera is known as Randia moss and it is found in the polar regions. Next type of lichen is found in the tropical rainforest and the example of it is Remolina reticulata. It can be found in the tropical rainforest. So this was all about the habit and habitat of the lichens. Now we will talk about the component of lichen. As I asserted you earlier that there are two components in the lichen. They are living in very close association. They are mycobind if we talk in terms of the fungal component, and they are phycobind if we talk in the term of the algal component. The mycobind is made up of two words. First is mycos and second word is bios. Mycos means fungus and bios means life. The member of fungi which form the lichen are of the member of Ascomycetes, Basidiomycetes and the imperfect fungus which is Deuteromycetes. In all three of them, Ascomycetes is found 98% times when we talk about the lichen. If Ascomycetes is present as mycobind, then that lichen will be known as Ascolichen. Ascolichen. If Basidiomycetes member are present as the mycobind, then the lichen will be known as Basidiolichen. Basidiolichen. And so is if as a mycobind the member of Deuteromycetes are found, then such lichen will be known as Deuterolichen. We talk about the function of the mycobind, then there are majorly three functions of it. The first and most important function is reproduction. Reproduction. As I told you just now that Ascomycetes member are found most abundantly. They are found around 98% times in the lichens. The members of Ascomycetes form the fruiting bodies which are known as ascocarp for the reproduction of the lichen. The second most important function of the lichen is to provide shelter to the algae. How we can say that it is a shelter? Because it is very necessary to save them against the dehydration, and this mycobind portion, it provide them the shelter and save them against the dehydration. There is one more important function that the mycobind does, that is absorption. Absorption. The mycobind portion or the fungus, it absorb the water and the mineral from the land, and it provide this to the phycobind so that phycobind can do photosynthesis function and can make food for the lichen. And phycobind is also made up of two words, that is phycos and bind. Phycos means alga or algae and bind means life. So algal life is there, okay. And apart of phycobind, if cyanobacteria is found as the photosynthetic portion, then it will be known as cyanobind. So phycobind and cyanobind, they might be the component of the lichens. If we talk about the phycobind or the true algae, then in most of the time the chlorophyce will be found as the phycobind, and these are the important members of chlorophyce like Triboxia, Tarantifolia, Coccomyxa and Petroderma. These are the common lichen which are found as a phycobind in the lichen. On the other hand, if we talk about the cyanobind or the blue-green algae which are not true algae, then Cytonema and Nostoc are the common example which are found in lichens. The function of the phycobind is very much important. The members of chlorophyce or the cyanophyce members, what they do? They do photosynthesis process. As algae absorb water and mineral for the phycobind, phycobind do photosynthesis with the help of pigment which are already present in these algae, and then they make food for the fungal portion as well as for itself. In such a way, a lichen can survive on the basis of the phycobind only, because they are making food, they are making carbohydrate for them to survive. So this was the general discussion about the lichen. I hope this video was helpful for you. If you like the video, please share it with your friends and press the like button, as well as please subscribe to our channel as we post such informative videos time to time. Stay tuned, and my name is Kanchan Sharma, and I thank you so much.